anonymous news. As the world turns, what's new has our full attention. Courage is contagious. Join us to post what mainstream media will not. The truth. If you don't want this read to you, click links below, thanks. WikiLeaks Stradfor emails suggest Bin Laden corpse brought to America. Friday, March 2, 2012. Internal emails in a major global intelligence firm, published by WikiLeaks, suggest that Osama bin Laden's body may have been brought to America after he was killed by the United States Navy SEALs. The emails, from the intelligence firm Stratfor, which offered services to major international corporations, are being published by the whistleblowing site, having been obtained in an attack on Stratfor's servers by the anonymous movement. In one email, sent by Stratfor's Vice President for Intelligence Fred Burton, and timestamped just hours after Barack Obama announced details of the Pakistani raid that killed bin Laden, Burton declares, reportedly, "We took the body with us. Thank goodness." Another, 25 minutes later, with the subject buddy bound for Dover, Delaware on CIA plane, adds, "Then, sick, onward to the Armed Forces Institute of Pathology in Bethesda." Dover, DE single quote, refers to Dover in Delaware, the site of a major Air Force base around 175 kilometers from Washington. In another email sent an hour later, Burton, who is considered a leading expert on terrorism and security, and who previously served as the second in command at the Department of State's Counterterrorism Division, adds, "If body dumped at sea, which I doubt, the touch is very Adolph Eichman, sick, like, the tribe did the same thing with the Nazis' ashes. We would want to photograph, DNA, fingerprint, etc. His body is a crime scene and I don't see the FBI not just letting that happen." Adolph Eichman was a leading organizer of the Holocaust who later fled to Argentina on a fake passport until he was captured by Mossad and brought to trial in Israel. He was executed and cremated and his ashes spread at sea, so that there could be no memorial to him. In response to that email, the company's CEO George Friedman, a child of Holocaust survivors, wrote, "Eichmann was seen alive for many months on trial before being sentenced to death and executed. No one wanted a monument to him, so they cremated him. But I don't know anyone who claimed he wasn't Eichmann. No comparison with suddenly burying him at sea without any chance to view him, which I doubt happened." Some 7 hours later, Burton responded again, "Body is Dover bound, should be here by now." While it is not clear whether Burton is relying on any internal military source or merely making an educated guess, and while it should be noted that the email exchanges begin with the word "reportedly," the emails, if true, would undermine the United States' claim that bin Laden's body was buried at sea within hours of his death. Previous emails from the Stratfor cache, which WikiLeaks says is made up of some 5 million emails, suggest that the Pakistani intelligence forces were aware of bin Laden's presence in the country, a charge Pakistan has consistently denied. The compound in which bin Laden lived and was killed, just outside Abbottabad, was torn down earlier this week. "Your government working to protect you. Itself. Please help, share this article with others, see links to this below, thanks. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you."